Hello everybody, welcome back to Swoody's Crafting Corner. Today we are going to cover how to build the Iron Nucleus, the Iron Golem Farm. Step 1, we'll build the collection and kill box. Start off with a double chest to collect the items in once they're destroyed, with 9 hoppers, as so. Decorative block of your choice. Around it like so. And now we're going to go up in the corners 3 blocks. Like so. Alright. Now you can fill this in with decorative blocks of your choice. I like to use glass, so we'll go in with glass, 2 high, all the way around to begin with. Like that. And now we're going to work on the kill system. So we're going to need a junk block here, with a sticky piston on top, a solid decorative block there, and fill it in with glass. You can destroy that junk block once you got the piston placed. Repeat the same thing on this side. Junk block, sticky piston, decorative block, and glass. Destroy that. We can fill in the back with glass like so. And that is the crush kill. To activate them, we're going to put in 2 more decorative blocks like so, and a couple of levers. So these levers will activate the crush. You hit them both and the iron golems will be crushed and killed. Alright, now we'll install the lava kill method. Put a dispenser here and here with a decorative block in between. Put a bucket of lava in each one of these. Next, we'll come down and put a few signs in. Like so. And that will give us a area for the lava to flow on. So you can see here we'll put a button. Now the lava comes out and it levels off on top of those signs. All the iron golems that fall in will get killed. Items will drop into the bucket. Now you may wonder why I have the crushing system when we have the lava system. In Minecraft 1.92, for some reason there's a bug that is causing the iron golems to swim or float. And so there is a marked decrease in iron drops from golems in lava right now. Maybe when they get that glitch fixed, it won't have that problem anymore, but for now, I have both. So you can let the golems collect and then you can come in and manually kill them, or if you're willing to just accept the drop in drops, you can use the lava and leave it on and it'll all automatically kill them all the time. And that completes step 1. Alright, for step 2, we're going to set up the initial waterworks that flow all of the outlying towers into the center, as well as the water for the first tier center collection, or a center farm. Alright, we'll start off with our quartz here. 1 block all the way around. With a 3 block tower in each corner. Like so. Alright, we'll start out with the sides first. For the sides, we're going to come out 8 blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. On all 3 of these centers. There. And I like to use glass, but you need some kind of block here, either a block with a half slab on top to prevent mob spawns, or glass or something that will block water and prevent mobs from spawning. Okay, come here, place 3 pressure plates, wood or stone, doesn't matter, and some water. Perfect. Do the same thing on this side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Alright, for the front and back, we're going to come out 10 blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And fill it out the same as before. Alright. And for the water, we're going to count out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9 blocks. And water on the 8th. Just like that. Same thing for the back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Six, seven, eight, and nine. Alright, there we go. Now, you may wonder why we set these up in the beginning, even though this is a modular design and you don't have to build the rest of the towers out to the edge, or you can build them at a later time. What this does is the initial spawns will this way get pushed into the middle and they won't be able to walk around the edge, and you won't have to come back in here and redesign it at a later time. Alright, now we're going to come out to the front and back, and we're going to build the drop-off points for the first village. So, one here, skip three, and one. One there, skip three, and one. And then build across the back here, like so. And place a couple more waters here, and I'll explain those a little bit later. Okay, now we'll come back over here. Cross like so. And then 8 blocks out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And 8. 1 block up, and then 8 blocks out. 1 block up, and 8 blocks out. Now, if you're wondering why this inside one is a different color, it's because this is going to be part of the actual spawn platform. It is within the spawn realm for the iron golems. We'll repeat the same process over here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Should stop right there. Alright, we'll do the same thing over here. Alright. And that completes step two, the waterworks. Alright, for step three, we'll be building the central spawn village. To do this, we'll start out right here. 1, 2, 3, 4. And I'm going to be using red glass to denote the glass. It has to be glass. 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Okay, from here we'll come out 8 blocks, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and square it off. Alright, just like the other side, we're going to come out 8 blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And we'll square this one off as well. And we'll delete these corner blocks. We're not going to need them, and this one will be covered up, and you'll see in a little bit why that is. Alright, now that we've got the platform built, we'll make the villager box. So we'll come up 2 blocks here. Actually, 3 blocks on the edges. I personally like to put lights in, but it is not required. And then a decorative block of your choice. I like to put in glass so that I can see the villagers, but you can put in, again, whatever kind of block you want to in this area. Now that we've got the block for the villagers, let's drop some in there. You're going to need 10 villagers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Once you got all 10 of those guys in there, we're going to lock them off with glass. Must be glass. Done with villagers for the moment. Next step we're going to do is you're going to take a sign, line yourself up with the villagers, walking backwards, crouching, and put a sign right there on the edge. Once you've got that sign on the edge, we'll put another sign here, and then 2 more coming off the sides. Like so. We're going to repeat this process on the other side, line ourselves up with the village. 1 off there, another 1 on top, 2 more to either side. Alright, once you've got those signs placed, now you can pull out the junk block of your choice, line up with this handy dandy little light, and just build a junk block all the way out to the edge. I again like to put a light in right here, but you guys can do whatever makes you happy. Decorative block of your choice out to the edge in either direction. We'll do this on both sides. Now, as you can see, the darker material here, this is the actual Iron Golem spawn area. This is the area where the golems will be spawning. The rest, everything else that's not colored is non-spawnable area. It is outside the central boundary spawn requirement. Alright, once you've got that outline all set up, now you come in with half slabs and cover all this up so that you don't have any unintended mobs spawning and gumming up the works. And there. Alright, almost done. One last thing to do on this bottom platform is to add the water. So right on top of these junk blocks, add your water. Once you've got water on top of all of them, you can destroy those junk blocks. Come around the other side, do the same thing. Alright, now you'll notice there is one gap right here in the middle, and this is where those signs come in. We're going to drop one bucket of water right here, lined up centered with the villagers, and it's going to push up against those signs and stop. Come across the other side and do the same thing. Alright, we have one full spawn platform done now. Now we'll work on the upstairs spawn platform. To do this, we're going to come in with a decorative block of your choice, line this whole thing, and another platform one block smaller. As such. Next, we'll place doors on every one of those solid blocks. If you're counting, you'll see this gives us 24 doors, which is more than the 21 needed to spawn a golem, plus the 10 villagers inside meets all the spawn requirements for iron golems. Next step, we'll take the decorative block of your choice, plop it right down on top of these doors in a 7x7 design. I personally like to take this center one out and lay another glowstone or light source block there. Again, with the glass, that must be glass, and some more decorative blocks. While we're here, we'll go ahead and half slab the top of this, being careful not to half slab over the top of the glass. Alright. Now for the second spawn platform. Lined up with the top of these doors here, we'll come out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And we'll just square that out. From here, it'll be just like the bottom one. Line yourself up with the red sign, come to the edge, sign, sign, and two more to either side. Got an iron golem spawned out here already, but I don't have the top platform, so he's not where he's supposed to be. Get down there. Alright, we'll fix that problem right quick. Let's take our trusty junk block, line it up to the center, all the way out. To the edge, and top it off with half slabs. Same thing over here. The edge and half slabs. Same thing over here. Alright, once you got that done, we'll come back and start adding the water in. Same as on the bottom, one on each type of these junk blocks, and then you can take them out. And one lined up with the glass. Same thing over here. And voila! That completes step 3. In step 4, I'll show you how to build the next village in the stack. Line yourself up here with the center. We'll take out this one. Alright, now what you're going to want to do is hit F3 and look at your Y coordinate. So if you take left hand side, middle, or about halfway down, you'll see XYZ equals and a whole bunch of numbers. You want to take that middle number, for me it's 65 right now, and you want to add 70 to it. Okay. Once you've added that 70, you're going to just nerd pull up until you hit the right number. So I'm going to be going up to 135. And there. Alright. Once you've gotten up there, you can get rid of that most annoying page there. We're going to come around to this side, we're going to build out 3 blocks. At the end of that third block, we'll put our spawn platform. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, followed by 7 glass. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and another 5 platform. Just like that. From here, we're going to go each edge out 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and square it off from there. Now you'll notice once this platform is built, it's going to be the exact same process as the platform down below. We'll start off with our villager box here. And I will do a speed build on this since it's going to be identical to what happened on the first platform. And that completes step number 4. For subsequent levels, all you gotta do is stand right back here and do the exact same thing you did last time. Look at your Y coordinate, add 70, climb up, and build your next village up. And as you can see, we already had one iron golem spawn. You can do up to 3. If you start at Y69 or below for this farm, you can build up to 3 tall without any issues. When you're done, you can jump off into the water, or you can destroy this tower. It's up to you. It doesn't matter either way and won't affect the farm whatsoever. However, if you do decide to leave it up there, you might want to put a half slab or something on top of it to prevent other mobs from spawning on it. Alright, in step number 5, I'm going to show you how to expand your waterways here so that you can add on the subsequent towers. Starting here, we're going to count it out 48 blocks. And then at the end of that 48, we're going to put a 5-block square. 4, 5, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 3, 4, 5, and finish that off. Now, because we are out in a part where we no longer have the roof of the spawning platform to keep the iron golems on there, we're going to need to make this wall too tall. Now, if you don't have a lot of glass to use, you can do glass on the top or and another block on the bottom, or you can do one block with a half slab on top. Either one should work. You just need something to prevent mobs from spawning and causing a ruckus. Now for the waterway itself. So using this first one, you're going to count out 9 blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Lay down 3 of those and 2 buckets of water. And repeat that process until you get close to the other end. And Now, if you're only going to do one set of towers here and not going to expand anymore, this is all you need to do. Just start here with the water and keep on going. But I'm going to show you how to do the full 9 towers. So I'm going to, it's kind of a different way of interconnecting the water streams here. So I'm going to make this next line out for the next set of towers and show you how the water interacts here. To do this, we're going to have to count out 56 blocks from here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And just like before, we'll make a 5 block. For tutorial purposes, I built a 5x5 block area here. When you make your next set of towers here, it'll be a little bit different because you'll have to set up the water collection system. But essentially, on that part right there and all the four corners, you're going to make an identical copy of the center pillar. So the same three that you make in the center, you're going to make right over there on that. So you'll have to align over the top of that 5x5 to match up the same as you would on this 5x5 with the water channels coming in, or however you want to set it up. But this 5x5 is the same as that 5x5 and should be lined up in the same manner with your spawn village that you build here and on the four corners. All four corners in the center are exactly the same. This water is a little bit easier because you don't have to count it out, you just gotta drop it down. Once you get to the end, drop the next one. Alright, now that we're getting close, I want to show you, I'm just going to build this out a little bit for tutorial sake. And just enough to run the water. But when you do this for an actual another village, it'll be identical to the one that you just made over here. Alright, to set the water up here, what you're going to do is you're going to put in a shape just like that. One bucket of water in this corner. You'll see this water comes up and flows. What we want to do is we want to block it off out here and do another set of water. You see how that pours out that direction? It doesn't have to be exact, but pretty close, just enough that it'll pour around that corner. Do the same thing here, and now you'll see all the waters will push. Because of the way golems are, the size of golems, they'll always be touching the water, and so they'll always get pushed around this corner. Now what you can do is drop it here, there, and it should line up perfectly. There you go. Okay, so that is how you'll do the one coming here for the large tower here and the short towers on either side. For the other tower over here, from here you're going to want to come out 46 blocks. At the end of this 46, just like before, we'll build a 5x5 platform. That will come back and destroy this water that we had set up. We won't be needing it. And because this one is going to be just a single tower at the end, we don't have to do anything fancy with the water. We just run it all the way down. Just like that. If you need proof of concept, as you can see, just in the amount of time that we've been working on the tutorial, there is a pretty good chunk of golems in there, and we've only got two villages spawning them right now, so this works pretty good. Alright, so the tower that you'll put here, the stack of villages you'll put here, is identical to all the ones you'll do on the, basically in a big cross sign. And starting from right here, you're going to want to look at your Y coordinate again, and you're going to go up 35 blocks. So 35 blocks, which puts me at 96. Alright, once we got up to that 96, we can get rid of that F3. We're going to come on down, and because of the way golems act, we want to actually enclose this entire fall chute. Alright, once you've got all the towers up to 35, we're going to go ahead and close them into a 5x5 circle. Alright, once you've got that 5x5 platform, we're going to count out 10 blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Bring the rest of these three out to meet it. Put our railing system in here. So, and as before, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Water, 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 water. Alright, do the same thing for the other side. Alright, now that we've got the waterworks set up, at least on this part, let's climb up one. Two, skip three here, 1, 2. 1, 2, skip three, 1, 2. And from this point, it'll be identical to the village and waterworks in steps 2 and 3. And that completes step number 6. This same process that I used here, the waterways and the interconnection here, is the same kind of thing you want to use on the corners out on the ends out there. You just build the same type of waterways, and then the rest is going to be just stacking them on top. The same thing for this. Now that this one's done, you just start right here, and just like you did in step number 4, you'll just go from here, build 70 blocks up, and make your next village. You can do 9 of them very easily in a very tight, less than 150 square blocks, and will produce over 1,000 block or 1,000 iron ingots an hour. That's going to be it for the tutorial, guys. You can see all 27 villages here. Things you can do to help yourselves out while laying these deals out is I like to use signs and count out each individual one. That way, if I lose count, I know that I've got it right. Every 5th block, I lay a sign down, and then I know that I actually have the distances measured out correctly. It works well for me, but everybody's got to find their own way. Another option, just to make it a little more user-friendly for the manual kill method. I know I promised no redstone on this design, and it does not require any redstone for the original design, but should you want to throw in a little pizzazz and make killing the iron golems a little bit easier, one thing that you can do is add in this small little pressure plate and redstone chain. It's very, very simple. Regular pressure plate there, and redstone going to a block, redstone torch, block, redstone torch, and that is it. Duplicate the same thing on the other side, and what happens is you walk up, stand on this pressure plate, and it automatically starts crushing and killing them. Makes it easy. Really, it's an option, so if you like it, use it. If you don't. It's completely up to you. As I said, if you're willing to use the lava method, you will have a substantial decrease in iron output, approximately 1/3, due to the golem swim glitch, but once that gets fixed, you should be good to go. Another item I would recommend is going to Nims Tut and using the item filter. Because of the amount of iron this thing is going to produce, you're going to want to have some substantial storage, and the item filter will help you out. It'll get rid of all these poppies and put them in a separate chest, allowing you to just put the iron you want inside the chest. So definitely check out Nims Tut. I'll put a link to his iron farm in the description so you can get a copy of how to make that filter. That's it, guys. Let me know what you think, and if you have any improvements or things you've done, or if you built them in your world and you want to showcase it, please let me know. Drop a comment, drop a link in the comments. Let me know. I'd love to see it. Thanks for watching, guys. Have a good one. Thanks for watching, everybody. If you liked the video, don't forget to leave a thumbs up. If you want to see more, subscribe to the channel. Some of my other playlists are right here. Just click on the picture. If there's something you liked or something you'd like to see, please leave a comment.